Welcome to the story behind the image. This is a photographic journey of my trip to Santo Domingo, Dominican Republic, in the spring of the year 2000. It was Discovery Health which hired me as part of their small television crew. We were to show a unique way of performing laparoscopic surgery in remote locations, using briefcase-sized satellite technology to utilize guided surgical assistance from experts at Yale University. At the Santo Domingo Airport, we discussed some of the finer details of what we were going to cover. It was a beautiful drive along the ocean to get from the airport to the downtown area. A site like this has always amazed me to no end. I've seen it in many third world countries, and it's as simple as you need some power, you climb up the pole and go get you some. Plenty of young entrepreneurs trying to give you the latest technology in cell phone chargers and carrying cases. Originally, Discovery Health wanted to perform these satellite surgeries in the jungles of Ecuador, but there was a coup and I think there was an earthquake around the same time, so we opted to go to Santo Domingo. The facilities here were incredibly modern compared to the situation we would have been in the jungles of Ecuador. We had a surprisingly small amount of gear. Because we designed it to be carried into the jungles of Ecuador, so we had as small and as minimum amount of equipment as we could possibly get away with. I mean, this is the studio. A couple flight cases full of monitors, a couple tape machines, audio mixing board, and a couple cameras. That's pretty much it. Discovery Channel producer Steve Reverend on the left was filling us in with all the details. These are the compact digital video tape recorders that we used. The monitors on the right would have the video from some of our cameras, some of the internal laparoscopic cameras, the feeds to and from Yale, and the telestrator feed from Yale. This is my audio setup, which is a simple 16-channel Mackie mixing board. I'm not sure if I like that hat. This is where it got interesting. On the right, you see the doctor has a headset microphone. And on the TV monitor are the list of commands that he would say, and the robotic instruments inside the patient would be doing these movements. Dr. Abel Gonzalez was the main surgeon. This is one of the satellite teleconference systems that we used for our communication back and forth to Yale. This is me trying to promote Mackie mixing boards again to see if I can get another magazine article. Let the surgeries begin. This is a shot of our live feed from Yale. The doctor from Yale would be able to see our surgeon here in the lower right-hand corner. It wasn't uncommon for me to have to walk into the OR during the middle of a surgery and make some minor adjustments. There was something surreal about walking into an OR during the middle of a surgery when you can just look over Dr. Gonzalez's shoulder to see the patient. This was part of the after party or after surgery festivities at the hospital. This may be the first time they ever scheduled a day off after a shoot. So we took our time and just enjoyed Santo Domingo. I've always been a big fan of sundials. I believe this to be the oldest building in the Western Hemisphere. And this is one of the caves outside the city. Boca Chica was the public beach just outside of town. Okay, so I hadn't had any sun yet this year. On our way to the airport, we stopped for lunch. I kind of like how you could just drive the car right up to the restaurant and there's like no walls anywhere. One of the most interesting parts of the trip was me trying to order food at this restaurant. When the waiter didn't understand my exceptionally poor Spanish, he took me back into the kitchen and he opened up the refrigerator to show me all the different fish that they had just caught. So I didn't know one fish from the next, so I just kind of pointed down at one, and later it showed up. I had no idea what kind of fish this was. I had no idea that the head would still be attached. I had no idea that the body would still be all intact. I kind of just sat there and looked at it for a while. But I am always one to try local customs. Wow, that was actually pretty good. I ate most of the other side and about this much of this side. I get kudos from everyone at the table for my performance in eating the demon fish.